Welcome to the SAP Production Planning course. In this lecture, we are going to see very basic concepts, mainly directed to students that don't have previous experience in SAP. In the next one, we will show an overview of the different processes covered by this SAP module and how they will be structured in this course. ERP stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. An ERP is an integrated information system for the management of a company or organization. When we say integrated, we mean that it should cover all or most of the organization processes, like finance, sales, purchase, or production ones. This information system will have to share data across all the different departments, as many pieces of information are saved for them. The aim is to have a unique database, only having to enter a piece of data once and being updated only in one place, that will allow to have quality data in real time, a feature that can save lots of work and facilitate decision taking. What is SAP? SAP stands for Systems Analysis and Programs Development. It is a company whose main product is an ERP called SAP ECC. This product is the one we are going to refer from now on when we say SAP. It is divided in different modules, each of them covering a department or area functionality. For instance, FI covers all finance processes, MM all purchase and inventory management process, and so on. A unique database is stored in SAP server, where an SAP instance of the software has been installed. And the different departments access through a client program installing their PCs, called SAP Win, but always to a central and unique database. What is SAP PP? SAP PP stands for Production Planning, and covers all the planning and production process of a manufacturing organization. Sometimes it can even implement it to manage certain services. It includes the maintenance of all master data needed for the management of these processes, materials planning data, bill of materials, routines, work center, etc. Demand management, how the demand enters our production unit, sales orders or independent requirements. The planning processes. Master Production Schedule, Material Requirement Planning, Consumption-Based Planning, and Capacity Management. And Production Control, a process that covers all the steps from the creation of a production order to the close of it. If we come back to the main picture, we can see that this module will include all the processes performed by the production departments, and that these processes will be very closely related to the purchasing inventory control ones, SAP MM, to know what we can produce and to update inventory levels once the manufacturing process has been finished. And it will also be very closely related to SAP SD, the sales and distribution module, to know what we need to manufacture and to notify when it is ready. But they will have an impact in finance and in controlling, to know how much does it cost to us to manufacture our product.